Deputy Noel Grealish, please.
Taoiseach, I believe this is going to be the last question
you will be asked as Taoiseach in this Dáil and Leaders' Questions. Unless Taoiseach, the wheel falls off the campaign of Leo's and Simon's leadership's challenge, you'll never know, you could be back again the week after next. Taoiseach, I got to know you first when I was elected a TD in 2002. At the same time, you became leader of a demoralised Fine Gael party, which had suffered severe losses and lost a lot of big names in that general election campaign. And I know the amount of energy and commitment you put in at that time to rebuild the Fine Gael party, travelling the length and breadth of the country. You were a man of huge energy, and I know that. And I have seen that especially since you took over the role of Taoiseach. There were times when I wondered what kept you going at such a pace. But as we all know, good things come to an end, Taoiseach. Taoiseach, I want to thank you for your friendship and your support during your term. I have to say that every time I contacted you with an issue of concern, you've always come back to me either by phone call or by text. And for that, I just want to say thanks. But Taoiseach, as you leave office, can I ask you to outline what do you consider were your greatest achievements? And also your biggest regrets. Everybody in politics will have some regret when they retire. If you had an opportunity to turn back the clock, Taoiseach, if you had an opportunity to turn back the clock, would you have appointed Simon or Leo to the cabinet, or would you have got Noel Rock to give his great speech? I think it was at 3 or 4 occasions on the nomination of Taoiseach. Of course, we cannot change the past, Taoiseach, and in this House we all do what we feel is right for our country. But finally, Taoiseach, I would ask you to outline what you feel are the main challenges facing the man who will succeed you in office, and what advice will you give the new Taoiseach?
And you will know what to respond.
That's a pretty novel question for the day that's in it.
How long have I got to come for that? I want to thank Deputy Grealish for the kindness of his comments. I hope to see you in Pier Stadium on Sunday week, and I hope you're as kind to me then when we take the field. I have absolutely no regrets at all about having appointed Minister Simon and Minister Leo. They were the two fine young men who have given me an opportunity. Yeah? Okay. They might not have been supporters of mine when my friend Richard took to the field a couple of years back. Be that as it may, I was actually happy to appoint them to front bench positions, to watch them grow as ministers, and to bring about a situation where they've very actively and vigorously campaigned for the right to lead this party around the country for the last number of weeks. And whatever the decision of the Fine Gael electorate around the country is, I hope that whichever of the two ministers is appointed as leader of the party will continue in government here and make decisions always in the interests of our people. And every decision that they make and every step that the government makes should be about the country and about the people, and I'm quite sure that's deeply embedded in their political philosophy. So from my perspective, I've been in the House a long time. I've seen all the tensions, all the outbreaks of viciousness, sometimes fisticuffs, when people moved on either after elections or in the course of being shoved out the gate. As far as I'm concerned, I've always made it clear that instinct is an important aspect of politicians and sports people indeed. I'm very happy after 42 years and 13 elections and 15 years as leader of a major party and six as Taoiseach, to in a position to move on responsibility to a younger generation. I think this is very important in all walks of life. As for your advice, I would say, you know, it's a little later than people think. There's no time to waste, and when the new government is appointed, in whatever structure that might be, it's got to get on with the challenges that we face of keeping our economy moving, of dealing with issues of child poverty, of homelessness, of provision of employment, and creating the infrastructure that we spoke about for people to live in this country over the next 30, 40 years. As for regrets, I don't have any. Anybody who stands in this position here, as Taoiseach of the country, had better have an optimistic and positive outlook. There is no point in going around looking like you're weighed down with the problems of the world. They've been there before us. You deal with them head on and make the best decisions that you can. But I think it's always, I could say this in Irish or in English, I suppose, but there was the old adage from the Latin phrase, illegitimae non carborundum, as you're all aware. And if you say it Osgoelge, you might say, no ligdo of Corastracorth Camor, Kibero the Yenistu. But thank you for your comments, Deputy Grealish. Appreciate that, and thank you, Ken Corley.
Deputy Grealish.
Taoiseach, how do I follow that? But I know you've made history and as your leader of Fine Gael, you've been the longest serving leader of Fine Gael, and also you're the first leader, Taoiseach from Fine Gael to be re-elected on two occasions. And I know that you are an avid GAA fan. I haven't seen you at the matches in Pier Stadium, and I think Minister Dinis Nocton and I put the fear of God into Simon and Leo there a number of weeks ago when we sent them a text message. And the text message read, I think, was that the Taoiseach in Kilkenny was going to announce the following morning that he'll step down 1 week after Mayo win the All-Ireland final. And I think poor Dinis would tell me poor Leo was crying in the corner, said he'll never see the job as Taoiseach. But anyhow, Taoiseach, and who knows, Taoiseach, but with your energy and your wide expertise and knowledge, you might get involved in the Mayo football team. And maybe you might bring that elusive Sam Maguire back to Mayo, but not at the expense of Galway, maybe at the expense of Cork or Kerry. But seriously and finally, Taoiseach, I would like to wish you, Fionnuala, and your family a long life and happiness together. And I am delighted to be able to call you a good friend. And I wish you the very best in the years ahead, Taoiseach.
Thank you, Deputy Grealish.
Appreciate your comments. I'll pass them on to somebody who is absolutely delighted.
leaders' questions.